It's time once again for that business show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ, where business becomes show business. Jamie is a leading Tampa Bay real estate agent and featured on the Wall Street Journal's list of top 100 real estate agents in the nation. Jamie invites you to list your home with him today and learn more at tampabayradio.com. Now, live in studio and promoting the entrepreneurial spirit that drives the American economy, your host, Jamie Maloney.
Hey, good morning, everybody, and happy Wednesday. And thanks for tuning in to the Working Women Wednesdays feature of That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Please take a moment and help support the show. As always, visit tampabayradio.com. Over there, lots of information, and we've put up the 2015 award winners that we hosted this past Monday night, a highly successful event, and just so happy to have the support from the business community behind the show as we turn pretty much 1 year old here at the end of this week. This is week 52 of That Business Show, which airs 5 days a week now here at 8 a.m. on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Also, keep in mind, the show is streamed here live in studio each and every morning. So if you're in your office and would like to catch the video, head over to tampabayradio.com and click on Watch Live Stream, and you can see the video here live in studio. And you probably would want to see this one today. We have a belly dancer here in studio, and sometime on the second part of the show, she's going to be doing a little bit of a belly dance routine for us. So you definitely want to catch the video for that one. It's, of course, Wednesdays, as I just noted, Working Women Wednesdays, weekly feature brought to us by the Working Women of Tampa Bay Networking Group. Please visit workingwomenoftampabay.com to learn more about this amazing networking group. On the phone line, CEO and founder Jessica Rivelli with me. Jessica, good morning to you.
Good morning, Jamie. How are you?
I'm still recovering from the Monday night. I'm just about there, but that was just so much work and so much follow-up. I'm still on little sleep, but it was a great awards night.
It really was a fantastic night to see that many people, you know, 140-plus people all packed into the room, all celebrating you and celebrating the show and really just celebrating the great energy that comes with, you know, collaboration in the Tampa Bay business community. It was an overall fantastic evening. I heard fantastic feedback, and it was funny to see so many people really get dressed up, and you know, they took the gala portion of the event pretty seriously. A lot of the ladies came dressed like they were going to the Oscars, and that goes to show you how much they really wanted to be there to celebrate with you, you know?
Yeah, and we had probably in excess of, I mean, the seating was for 140, but I think we probably squeezed about 150 people into that room. We had to pull some extra chairs in there, and we announced 11 different awards. Talk to us about the Working Woman of the Year, who was Michelle Northrup.
Yeah, well, you know what I was really just wowed by was the fact that I think we had about six categories where Working Women members won. So, of course, we were celebrating. But Michelle Northrup won Woman of the Year, Working Woman of the Year, and she definitely she deserved the award. She's actually a founding member of our organization, so she's been with us for about 7 years now. But I think what makes Michelle so special is her desire to give back to the community. And this is a perfect number to highlight just how much love she has. When she posted that she won on Facebook, that particular post, I think, currently has 700 likes.
Yeah, it's incredible.
700 likes.
Yeah, it's incredible.
I mean, people love her, and it's because she's a great mentor. She gives back to the community, and she's saucy, as she'll be the first one to tell you. So, a much-deserved win. All five of the women in that category were stellar, dynamic, amazing women. They all deserve to win. But I think Michelle's win is particularly sweet this year. And it was a day before her birthday. Yesterday was her birthday. So it was a nice kickoff to her birthday celebration. So much love for Michelle. And like I said, Working Women as an organization was just over the moon that we had six different members win in different categories, and our corporate sponsor, Pure Life Med Spa, Dr. Fitz, who is the medical director of the med spa, one in the doctor category. So it was a fantastic night for working women, for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. And another thing, whenever I post the show cards on my Facebook fan page, which is facebook.com/thatbusinessshow, if I post just general posts, I get maybe like 30 to 40 reach on those things. The reach is terrible. But when I posted your show card and some of the other working women members, and without promotion, you yourself had 3,000 people that it reached, and all the other working women were in the 1 to 2,000 category. It's incredible. I don't know what's going on, but somehow Facebook knows that Working Women Wednesdays is a very popular show.
Well, yeah, and I think it's just because women in general tend to be more social. They tend to be on Facebook and Twitter a little bit more than men, and our women particularly love to share things. So, you know, that's just part of our bigger community. They're women that really want to see other women do well, and I think that when we post the show cards and when we post, like the awards that we did, I was kind of doing like a, every time someone would win, I would post it on my Facebook page. And Andrea Harrison, who won in the
Best on Air,
Best on Air, she had like 150 likes just from my post. So I just think it goes to show you that women, and then specifically working women in Tampa Bay, they want to give each other praise, and they want to be able to help one another, and sharing on social is one way to help. It's a free way to help, right?
Yep, and the most inspirational story was another Working Women Wednesdays member here, Maya Kazajic, who is a Bosnian war survivor, was in last year and told an amazing story of survival of how coming to the States.
Supergirl.
Yes, yeah, and she was also a speaker at a couple of your events, or one of your events last year.
Yeah, that's how we first came to know her. She came to a Working Women event back in January of last year, and then I was just so awe-inspired by her story that when I went to book my keynote for International Women's Day, I said, Maya, would you please, do us the honor? And I have to tell you, Jamie, when we were, she told her story, that it was a packed house, we had about 260 women last year. And when she was telling her story about the day that the bombs went off and she lost her legs, you couldn't hear crickets. I mean, it was so quiet. You could hear a pin drop. And that was because the women were just so captivated by not only her story, but her storytelling. I mean, she really kind of took us there. And we could really, I feel like everyone in that room really kind of experienced what she went through that day. She's just an amazing woman. The fact that she's been able to, obviously learn to walk again, and not only learn to walk, but really be now a motivational speaker and someone that people can look up to as someone who's overcome adversity and done it in a spectacular way. So she very much deserved to win on Monday night as well.
Yeah, and part of her story that she shared with me was after she was in the hospital there in Bosnia there, and her legs were damaged really badly, and then she had to make a decision within like 10 or 15 minutes. She was, I think, randomly selected to go to the United States for recovery, and she had to leave her family, and she had to make the decision within like a 5 to 10 minute window, and it was a very heartbreaking decision that she had to make to leave her friends and family, in the war-torn country.
Yeah, of course, especially when you know that some of them are injured, but yes, I think she talks about this guardian angel woman who came into the hospital and kind of rounded up children to take them to America, and she made that brave decision, and now she's here and very much, I think, loves being part of America. So, and we love Maya. She's definitely an important part of our organization.
Another winner from the night, I'm not positive she's a member, Stevie Morgan, Cater Me Fit, best startup company.
Stevie just became a member.
She just became one, cool.
This is a good segue because Stevie is catering our meals up to Tallahassee. So we're actually on our way in about an hour to head up to Tallahassee for Women's Day at the Capitol. And Stevie is the one providing all the healthy meals for the bus so that we don't have to stop and get fast food. So she's amazing. She's a woman to watch. Every time I talk to her, her business is just so rapidly growing that she's really kind of got to, buckle up, because she's going to have an amazing ride in the next couple years. And she's brand new to us. She's only been a member for a couple months, but but we're really excited for her to be a part of Working Women, and we're really excited to taste her meals today, to be honest.
Yeah, and I've been promising her that I'm going to get on the bandwagon for the Cater Me Fit meals, too. I definitely need to slim down here in this 2016,
no.
So I'm gonna buy into her program here, too. So, but CaterMeFit.com, a great meal delivery service, and her own father lost 100 pounds. That was actually part of the catalyst in growing her company there, was what the results she had on her own father.
Well, and you hear this every day as you interview entrepreneurs all over the Tampa Bay area, and I'm an example of this. When you see a void or a gap in the market because of your own life, right? So for me, it was I was looking for women networking, and I wanted something that was for professional women, and I wanted it to be all-inclusive, and so that it was, you know, come one, come all. So I had that need in my own life. I couldn't find it, and I created it. Stevie's got that same story. She wanted to make sure that her dad was going to be healthy because he was eating fast food and all sorts of pizza, especially during lunchtime, because that was his only options when he was sitting there at his desk at work. And so she filled that void in her life, and in his life specifically. And because of that, she has, you know, a very prosperous, growing company. And that's a story that you hear time and time again, not just among women, but among, you know, men who have gone started their entrepreneurial journey. It's because they just wanted to fill a void in their life and saw, obviously, a huge gap in the market. And Stevie's been successful. I've been successful. And, you know, many other entrepreneurs in Tampa Bay have been successful just solving a problem in their own lives.
Yeah, and you've done a great job with the Working Women of Tampa Bay Networking Group. Jessica, as always, I appreciate the support each and every Wednesdays here on Working Women Wednesdays.
Have a great show and enjoy that belly dancing.
I think we will.
All about it.
Thank you, Jessica. And again, that was Jessica Rivelli, CEO and founder of the Working Women of Tampa Bay Network Group. Learn more about them and their many events over at workingwomenoftampabay.com. Stay tuned. We got a belly dancer here in studio. So if you're near a computer, head over to tampabayradio.com and click on the watch live stream, and you'll be able to see that. And you're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Are you in need of new flooring or ready to tackle that home remodeling project? Then contact Yeager & Company Incorporated, a family-owned, state-certified general contracting business with over 70 years of experience and the recipient of the Angie's List Super Service Award for the last 8 years in multiple categories. Yeager & Company comes to you with their shop-at-home flooring sales service, and their hardwood flooring refinishing is the very best in the Bay. Kitchen and bath design featuring American-made well-born cabinets, and all work is done by employees, not subcontractors. Learn more at YeagerFlooring.com.
Tampa Bay weather is a roof killer. That's why when getting your roof done, you want it done right. Hi, I'm Jamie Maloney of That Business Show. When considering a new roof or repair, talk to Westfall Roofing. They've been installing high-quality roofs in Tampa Bay for over 25 years. Get a free, no-obligation estimate by calling 855-99-ROOFING. That's 855-99-ROOFING. Find out what already 15,000 satisfied customers already know. Call now, 855-99-ROOFING. In an age when the good and the better vie for attention, it is the best that stands out. The best of Tampa Bay from proudly Florida is the love story for the city of Tampa, celebrating success, sharing achievements, a tribute to enterprise and community spirit. Let proudly Florida showcase your business to your city, your nation, and the world. For more information, email info@proudlyflorida.com and be sure to visit proudlyflorida.com. If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Taseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at ricktaseda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Taseda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project.
Have you ever tried to buy a home for your family only to find out that you don't qualify for a mortgage loan? You thought that after 20 years as a customer of your bank, they would help you when you needed it the most, right? Unfortunately, the banks of today are not the banks of our parents and grandparents, and our relationships with them just don't matter anymore. My name is Frank Cotto, and I'm the president of the Lincoln Lending Group. We all may need a bank, but we also need a Frank. And that's what I'm here to do for you today. Lincoln Lending Group will waive all of your lending fees, which include your mortgage, application fee, your underwriting fee, processing fees, and any bank points. Just call 813-MORTGAGE. You drop the E, and we'll drop the fee.
From the Bright House Network's Traffic Center.
That road's making for a slow ride around Tampa Bay. Westbound I-4, it is slow from 301 to 50th Street, southbound 275 from Beers to Hillsboro. Crash on Hillsboro at Anderson, also one being cleared at Webb, southbound Veterans Expressway. Typical delays there. Northbound, there's a crash near Waters, northbound 275 in St. Petersburg. Crash near 22nd Avenue North, now off to the side. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abraham Sun New York, Hillsboro Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by the Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer. The Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer is so fast, accurate, and easy that it takes the hassle out of taking temperature. It is an awesome purchase. Every new parent should have one. Pick one up at your local club warehouse or other fine retailers today.
Today, an 80% chance of showers and storms, some with heavy downpours, a high 71. Tonight, rain continues, low 63. Tomorrow, a 50-50 rain chance, high 68.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 WINS WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And we're back to the program, everybody, and thanks for staying tuned in to the Working Woman Wednesdays feature of That Business Show with Jamie Maloney. This weekly feature brought to us by the amazing networking group at the Working Women of Tampa Bay. Learn more about them, WorkingWomenOfTampaBay.com. They got lots of different events and an excellent resource for professional women in and around the Tampa Bay region. Also, please help support the show and visit TampaBayRadio.com. Over there, all shows are available on demand, and you can check out all the local real estate listings, as I am a realtor with Coldwell Banker. That's what I do each and every day after I do the radio show, and I want to be your resource for buying and selling real estate in the region. So please reach out to me if I can in any way help you with that. There is a contact form on TampaBayRadio.com. Just put in your information there and send me a message, and we'll see about getting you hooked up with me and helping you out in the Tampa Bay real estate market. Time to bring on my guests for the program. We're going to have a group discussion today, so I'm going to introduce them both right now. We have Sherry Kendrick, who is the owner of Sherry Kendrick Photography and also founder of the 501c3 Little Light of Mine, and she's joined in studio today by Johanna Zenobia Krenitsky, the owner of Hip Expressions. Working with Karen Ray Sunray, they founded Hip Expressions Belly Dance in 2004, reaching out to women of all ages, shapes, and sizes. Johanna and Sherry, welcome to the program today.
Good morning.
So, Johanna, I will start with you. How did you become a belly dancer?
Well, my grandma was touring the world and decided to take me with her so I could help her carry rugs back from Istanbul. So we went to Turkey, and that's where I saw my first belly dancer. And I'd never seen belly dancing before, and I just fell in love with it. I always grew up dancing and high school dances, and I would always do like the little white girl shuffle. But I went out to the Turkish nightclubs, and everybody's dancing. Men, women, children, everybody's just out there enjoying their body, moving freely. And I said, I don't know what that is, but I want it. So I came back to the States and started taking classes, and was working at the museum at the time in Chicago.
Now, I see that you say that belly dancing is for people of all shapes and sizes. I have a hard time seeing a person that is overweight trying to partake in the belly dancing art, but you're saying this works for people of all shapes and sizes?
Absolutely. I mean, belly dancing, it's just how people dance. So it's a community dance. It's very much about women getting together, men getting together, and everybody celebrating. So they're playing music, they're dancing, so all ages, shapes, and sizes, just like you would see at any party, put on some music, everybody's going to dance a little bit.
Okay, and so where are you located at?
We're in Northeast St. Pete on 54th Avenue North, just off of 275, which is a great location. And people come to us from all over, Sarasota, Tampa, Bradenton, and of course right here in St. Pete.
And you're the co-founder of this with a partner. And how did this all come together? Tell me about how you put this together.
Well, I moved to the area and decided that life was too short not to follow your passion. So I knew I loved the body and dance, and I wanted to share that and help inspire other people too. And I moved here, I met Karen, and we just started working together and collaborating and performing in the restaurants around, Turkish, Persian, Egyptian restaurants, and just started teaching classes, and more people kept coming to classes and finding that they could really express themselves through dance. And it's a fun way to stay in shape. You know, everybody's sick of going to the gym and running on the machines, but here you can work out and have a good time. And it's very much about the community. So it's about men, women, children, everybody coming together.
I notice you're throwing out there different art forms or different dance styles. So you come to your studio and you have the Arabic style, the Turkish style. I don't even know what styles are out there. I'm just naming different countries.
Yeah, Is there a South American style?
Is there an American? What's the American style? Is it just kind of the basic head bob, you know? Yeah. What are these different styles
mean
like?
Mean mug in the back of the clothes. That's what I do.
Actually, there is an American style, and it's come together from all these fusions. Actually, it fuses flamenco and Indian dance and belly dance. It's called American tribal style belly dance. So it's recognizing that we're from tribes all over the world and we can come together and create a new style and dance to whatever music is on the radio, Shakira or hip hop or even jazz. We can belly dance to pretty much anything.
What is your favorite artistic expression or favorite type of dancing, I should say?
Favorite type of dancing. Well, belly dance, but to non-traditional music. I love the improvisation of jazz. I love improvising with live music. I work with a couple of bands around the Tampa Bay area. One is called Kafkaso, and he's a Turkish guy that plays Nuevo Flamenco music. So we get out there and do a little bit of Latin-Turkish belly dance fusion. And it's that interaction between the live music and the dance that was really amazing and special. It's all about being in the moment and just enjoying your body, being in this lifetime, being in this expression, and getting the music to move you.
Do you do couples dancing too? Is this all individual type of expressions?
Well,
how does the classes
belly dancing
work?
We did start as belly dancing, which is about individual expression, mm-hmm. but our studio has expanded. So when we expanded 4.5 years ago, we added ballroom, salsa, jazz. We've got cardio samba classes. We have a dance form called Neo, which is dance aerobic. So everybody who's like a little shy for belly dancing but still wants to dance and work out, they come for the Neo classes. They're actually our second most popular class.
And then do you get guys that try belly dancing at all?
Or sure. We have a guy, male belly dancer that works at the studio, actually.
I would love to see
Sultan
this,
Sultan Shev. He is fantastic. He combines ballroom and belly dancing.
There you
she
go, Josh.
Sultan. Yeah, you're a Sultan.
I'm the Sultan.
Past life.
Oh, yeah. We'll get Sultan Shev on out here to show
Sultan
you
Jamie.
Well, I am the worst mover when it comes to dancer. Like I said, I have a few basic dance moves, the basic head bob, the one-arm fist pump, and the two-arm overhead thrust with Yale. And I learned that from the Blue Man Group, if anybody follows the Blue Man Group
absolutely.
Out there. Are you familiar with
absolutely,
the Blue Man Group?
Absolutely.
Yeah, they have their rock concert movement concert series and a fascinating group. Go ahead.
It's amazing how much belly dance improves your concentration, improves your coordination, improves your posture. Chiropractors actually recommend it if you've got back problems. I myself have 8 herniated discs and triple scoliosis, and I find that doing yoga and belly dance and just staying conscious of my breath and my body has completely helped me. I think I would be 3 inches shorter if I wasn't belly dancing.
I was going to say, I mean, I watch people move, and I would think my back would be sore for a week after making the movements that belly dancers move.
Well,
I mean, how is it that it helps the back? I don't get this.
It's all about building the core, so it's supporting the spine. Joseph Pilates even says, you're only as young as your spine is flexible. Well, belly dancing is going to work all your core muscles, your back, your abs, your glutes, your legs, everything that'll keep your spine flexible and keep everything flowing and keep you young.
Interesting. Sherry, let me throw it over to you. You're a photographer and you're also the founder of the new 501c3 Little Light of Mine. What is the mission of Little Light of Mine?
Little Light of Mine is a community program that offers complimentary photography services to children and families that have a child in the family with a life-threatening or life-limiting illness.
Okay. How did this come about? What was the catalyst for starting this 501c3?
I started my for-profit regular portrait business in 1999. And within a few years of that, I actually got a call from a woman who had a husband who was in hospice and was not expected to make it too much longer than that. And it took her a couple of phone calls to even get the request out to me on the phone. She kept crying and hanging up. And when we finally, I got the idea of it, and we went and I did the photo shoot. And it was really a very, I guess, a pivotal point in my thinking of taking on this time of life, the end of life type of photography. So we did the photo shoot, and it was really sweet. It was an older couple. And he did pass within 24 hours of the photo shoot. And so I expedited the photos to her. And when I was invited to the funeral, I went to the funeral, and it was very moving. And all of the photographs that I had taken were up. And the woman was very grateful, of course, for the photography, but she was also grateful for just having that experience of, she had told me that within the previous 12 months, their lives had evolved into just one doctor visit after another and everything medical.
Hold that point there. I got to take a quick break. I'll let you finish that point coming back from the break. Currently in studio with Johanna Krenitsky and also Sherry Kendrick, founder of Little Light of Mine. You can learn more about her, llom.org. We'll continue that discussion when we come back from the break. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Hi, welcome to Jaeger's. We just want to take a minute and show you what we're all about. At Jaeger's, our primary business is hardwood flooring. although we are remodelers for kitchen, bath, and general construction. We operate a fleet of shop-at-home vans that have all the flooring-type products, hardwood flooring, laminate flooring, tile, stone, what have you. So we're able to come out first with products in our vehicles and take a look at the setting, how the colors will work, and then to be able to come up with some options and ideas for you. If that's not good enough, we have a large distribution center that we inventory product and have a nice display area.
Roads making for a slow ride around Tampa Bay. Westbound I-4, it is slow from 301 to 50th Street, southbound 275 from Beers to Hillsboro. Crash on Hillsboro at Anderson, also one being cleared at Webb, southbound Veterans Expressway. Typical delays there. Northbound, there's a crash near Waters, northbound 275 in St. Petersburg. Crash near 22nd Avenue North, now off to the side. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abraham Sun New York, Hillsboro Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9590.
This report is brought to you by Just Brakes.
For a limited time at Just Brakes, basic brake service is just $79 per axle. We'll install new pads, recondition rotors, and test a brake fluid. Visit JustBrakes.com for our $79 brake service today.
The brake store that gives you more. Just Brakes.
Winds, weather center forecast, but a gloomy day. We'll stay cloudy, rain chance at 80%, showers and some storms likely. 70 for the high today, tonight's low in the lower 60s. Going to see showers into the morning through Thursday, then wake up cloudy and windy, then windy with mix of sun and clouds Friday, mid-60s. Impact Radio, 1250 Winds.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to the Working Woman Wednesday's feature of That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Sherry, you were telling us there the story of how you came to found the 501c3 Little Light of Mine. Go ahead and continue that.
Okay, so I was shooting the couple. He passed away when we were talking about the experience. She had explained to me how her life was one doctor visit after another, and you know, the nurses and making sure everything was okay. And while we did the photo shoot, I had them embrace each other and they laughed, and I'm pretty funny, so I was cracking a lot of jokes, you know, and cracking them up. And and I could see it happening. I could see that they were just, you know, at this one point, just relax into each other, into an embrace. And I had all these photographs of them laughing and embracing. So it was not just the photographs that they received that they were grateful for, but she was also very grateful for just bringing them back together in that moment.
That's when you had your vision to start Little Light of Mine?
That was the first time the seed was planted to offer this service, and how crucial it is. You know, I mean, I think everybody can relate to how precious photographs are to them, no matter what your story is. And when you lose somebody, that is all you have left. So
what are your needs from the community? This is in its infancy, 501c3. How's the development of it coming along right now? What can the community do to help support you?
Well, we only have a few minutes, but in a nutshell, we are just securing a studio space for Little Light of Mine. We do new funding now to support our monthly expenses. We are getting ready to launch a campaign to do monthly sustainers. We're trying to get about 250 people to pledge $15 a month to just have that monthly income coming in so that we don't have to stress every month.
Where can they make the donations? Do you have a GoFundMe page?
No, we have a website, and go into the website with a very open mind that we are in our infancy and we are looking for a website designer to help us out with that. But it is llom.org, and there is a PayPal donate button, and you can do a monthly pledge on there.
Well, the development of any business or any idea takes time to develop. And yeah. Even my show, you know, has come together from just different, you know, people helping out throughout the year. So, I mean, it's just in its infancy, and it's something that you're growing. So I commend you for having the vision that you have.
Thank you.
And you're also looking for board members and people to get involved with the actual operation of the
photographers, especially anyone who's
got one right here in the room, Rick Toseda here.
Yes.
He's in here each and every morning.
We're building a team of photographers. We have about 5 solid photographers on our team now. We are very much short-staffed to support the demand in the community for this, which I was surprised. It started as a very small little project that I was going to do 4 hours a month as a volunteer basis, just me. Mm-hmm. And as soon as I started working with the hospital, All Children's Hospital, I realized that there was far more demand than I could support on my own. And then,
do you have fundraisers planned for raising money for Little Light of Mine? What do you have on the horizon for this?
Well, we just did our first fundraiser at Nova 535 in November, and that's going to be an annual event. So right now we have that in November of 2016, mm-hmm. but I'm sure we'll have stuff. We are looking for a fundraising expert.
I'm not really a fundraising expert, but there's been plenty of people that have been on this program that are.
Yes.
So I can definitely connect you with people. And anybody that's out there in the community that's listening, I've probably spoken with somebody that can help you in some way with your business or your organization. So if I could ever be of any help in that arena, please reach out to me. I can definitely help you in that. And I can definitely hook you up with people that are experts in fundraising as well. And so your organization then works with people in kind of end-of-life moments, and you donate your photography services. And, I mean, that's so appreciated. I mean, it's so good that you do that, because that's, you know, I mean, where else? Because people probably don't have the finances to put this together when they're dealing with end of life expenses.
Correct. And you know, I mean, even for the most affluent families with insurance, I end up really struggling financially once they have a child that's in this position. Your co-payments and deductibles will just.
So it's a great service and a great organization that you've put together here. Again, llom.org, if you would like to make some donations to this 501c3, again, Little Light of Mine. Johanna, you've dealt with breast cancer yourself. Tell us the story of how you overcame this.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you think that you go through life and enjoying it, but then at some point it's like you're faced with that reality of life or death. So that's why I believe it's really important to grab every precious moment and enjoy it and explore it to the fullest. When I was diagnosed with breast cancer 9 years ago, I did not have health insurance. And so I was a professional belly dance artist. And so I was faced with a lot of challenges and expenses. And I was amazed how much belly dancers have a nationwide network and community. I had fundraisers for me in New Orleans, in DC, in California. My belly dancing friends all over the US actually pitched in and raised over $25,000 to raise funds for my mastectomy and my chemotherapy.
So the dance treatment. Community came together for
Absolutely.
You?
Absolutely.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely.
How was the discovery? Was it found in a basic mammogram or?
It was not. Mammograms often don't discover it. So I had an ultrasound and mammogram that didn't find anything. But I had some bloody discharge coming out. So I had that sort of investigated, and that's what it ended up being. But you know, at the time, I'm very much a natural treatment sort of gal, and I have a hard time trusting any doctors, but I have a friend who's a belly dancer and I knew she had a medi spa down in Sarasota, Marguerite Barnett, and I reached out to her, Mandala Medi Spa, and I said, Marguerite, what can I do? And she said, you know, I'm double board certified. I am I can do your mastectomy and your reconstruction. And she said, and I won't charge you anything.
Oh, wow.
And what surgeon says that? And I said, Marguerite, you can't, that's ridiculous. I can't ask you. And she says, I'm giving it. I'm not. She says, honestly, it's just a couple hours of my time.
Wow. How long did the battle with the breast cancer go on for?
It was really quick. It was like, it was about 6-7 months until
did it derail your dancing career much, or were you able to?
Absolutely. I mean, that was part of the problem, is I was running the dance studio at the time. And we had all these classes to teach. So that's when Karen, my partner, really stepped up and helped run things while I was not able to dance. And of course, not able to perform. And you know, mastectomy and chemotherapy, and I had long blonde hair down to my butt, and that all came out.
So the dance community that came together to help you raise the funds for this, mm-hmm. was this something that you put together, or was this that they came together on their own?
We have a local community, and so Karen really spearheaded that in terms of doing some local fundraisers. There were several fundraisers around town. But then once sort of word got out into this nationwide network, then they just sort of stepped forward and made donations. And I was so touched by how much the community, I had no idea I had this all support. And I thought, you know, I don't deserve this. Who am I that I deserve all this support? But they said, you're part of the community. We're going to help you out. So that has so inspired me to give back to the community by creating the dance studio, which is not just, you know, Johanna's dance studio. It's a community space. People come in, they feel at home. We've got yoga, belly dance. We've got all sorts of healing arts. We have massage therapy. And that's really inspired me to keep to give back to the community and honor that and keep that alive.
Yeah, I noticed on your website that you're more than just a dance studio now. People can visit hip-expressions.com. I see you're a spa, massage. What are some of the other services that are offered there?
We do monthly gatherings. We do shows. We do women's gatherings. We have capoeira. We've got some martial arts. We've got acro balancing. So it's dancers and yogis and musicians. We're going to be having some kirtan events. So it's like a spiritual...
Kirtan, what is that?
It's like a spiritual drum circle. It's a yoga event with chanting and dance, free dancing. So it's really a safe place. We have ecstatic dance, a safe place to really explore how do you be inspired and be you. And again, back to celebrating that moment because we know how precious life is. So let's seize every moment to honor each other and honor ourselves.
And now, do you just have the one location right now?
Right now, we do have the one location. Okay. We've been asked to open more, but one step at a time.
I was going
to
ask you, when are you going to branch out and open up another location?
Absolutely.
Looks like you got this one down pretty good. Yeah. Time to expand.
Well, and I also want to reach out to people who can't afford dancing, children and women who it's maybe out of their price range, but they want to explore that creative side. So we were talking in the car, Sherry and I, about what it would take to start up some foundation that would help out with some of that, too.
Now, I noticed on your show card, Zenobia, where does this name come from?
Zenobia is my mother's middle name, and it's also the name of the Queen of Persia at the time of Alexander the Great. So when I started belly dancing, that was sort of the fashion to take a dance name, so I chose a family name. And then I moved here, and I was Zenobia, but I also Johanna, so now I use both. But it's right. A way to honor my heritage and also the background of this beautiful dance world.
Well, I love the name, Johanna Zenobia Krenitsky. That's a very great... Where's Krenitsky? What origin is
Ukrainian.
That?
Ukrainian. My family's Ukrainian.
Oh, interesting. Aside to that, my brother is actually about to go to the Ukraine for two and a half years as part of the Peace Corps.
Nice,
so,
nice.
He's actually coming down next month
to see me. I'm first-generation Ukrainian-American, so I grew
up a little bit worried
language.
Because of the Russian conflict. Is that settled down? I haven't heard too much about that in the media lately.
No, it's, the media focuses on what it focuses, but it's very much a struggle. My family is very involved, actually, with sending help over to the Ukrainian troops so that they can help keep their independence.
Wow. So, my brother's going over there into a war zone.
The struggle is
real. Wow. He's been trying to get into the Peace Corps for like 12 years, and he finally got accepted into it. He's a university professor right now, double master's degrees in history and English, and he's going over to the Ukraine to work for pennies, because they really just give you basic living expenses. And I think he lives with a host family on top of that. So.
Wow.
But good to know I have a resource about Ukrainian culture. So if he doesn't know something, I'm going to come ask you.
Yeah, it's amazing when things I try to instill in my students is gratitude, the fact that we live in a day and an age and a time where we can dance freely wherever we want. This is not something that we can take for granted all over the world. And here in America, I think we take a lot of things for granted because that's just the way we do things. But it's not the case all over the world that women can dance freely as they wish.
Yeah, good information. Got to take a quick break. But coming back from the break, we're going to have Johanna do a belly dance for us. So if you're near a computer, you can watch this here on the video. Just head over to TampaBayRadio.com and click on the Watch Live Stream button. And also please help support Sherry Kendrick, founder of Little Light of Mine. She's looking for support, board of directors. Anybody can help with a website. It's a startup 501c3, and you can learn more about her, LLOM.org. You're listening to the Working Women Wednesdays feature of That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Are you in need of new flooring or ready to tackle that home remodeling project? Then contact Yeager & Company Incorporated, a family-owned, state-certified general contracting business with over 70 years of experience and the recipient of the Angie's List Super Service Award for the last 8 years in multiple categories. Yeager & Company comes to you with their shop-at-home flooring sales service, and their hardwood flooring refinishing is the very best in the Bay. Kitchen and bath design featuring American-made well-borne cabinets, and all work is done by employees, not subcontractors. Learn more at YeagerFlooring.com.
Tampa Bay weather is a roof killer. That's why when getting your roof done, you want it done right.
Hi, I'm Jamie Maloney of That Business Show. When considering a new roof or repair, talk to Westfall Roofing. They've been installing high-quality roofs in Tampa Bay for over 25 years. Get a free, no-obligation estimate by calling 855-99-ROOFING. That's 855-99-ROOFING. Find out what already 15,000 satisfied customers already know. Call now, 855-99-ROOFING. In an age when the good and the better vie for attention, it is the best that stands out. The best of Tampa Bay from proudly Florida is the love story for the city of Tampa, celebrating success, sharing achievements, a tribute to enterprise and community spirit. Let Proudly Florida showcase your business to your city, your nation, and the world. For more information, email info@proudlyflorida.com and be sure to visit proudlyflorida.com. If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Caseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at ricktaseda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Caseda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project.
Have you ever tried to buy a home for your family only to find out that you don't qualify for a mortgage loan? You thought that after 20 years as a customer of your bank, they would help you when you needed it the most, right? Unfortunately, the banks of today are not the banks of our parents and grandparents, and our relationships with them just don't matter anymore. My name is Frank Cotto, and I'm the president of the Lincoln Lending Group. We all may need a bank, but we also need a Frank, and that's what I'm here to do for you today. Lincoln Lending Group will waive all of your lending fees, which include your mortgage, application fee, your underwriting fee, processing fees, and any bank points. Just call 813-MORTGAGE. You drop the E, and we'll drop the fee.
From the Bright House Network's Traffic Center.
Crash on southbound US 19 at Bel Air. Also, 38th Avenue North remains closed just east of 49th Street due to an accident investigation. Northbound I-75 at Sun City Center. Crash there off to the side. Southbound 75, slow between Fletcher and I-4. Southbound 275 between Beers and Sly. And a crash on Hillsborough Avenue at Anderson. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abrahamson Utrecht Hillsborough Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by the Tampa Bay Downs. Live thoroughbred horse racing 4 days a week, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at Tampa Bay Downs. You can have a lot of fun and maybe win a little money watching the horses run. Grandstand admission is free on weekdays and only $2 on weekends. Tampa Bay Downs. Live it up at the Downs.
Today, an 80% chance of showers and storms, some with heavy downpours, a high 71. Tonight, rain continues, low 63. Tomorrow, a 50-50 rain chance, high 68.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 WINS WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to the program, everybody. You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. And it's also the Working Woman Wednesdays feature of That Business Show. So please head over to WorkingWomenOfTampaBay.com and check out some of their many events. You can always go to one of those events for free of charge and reach out to Jess and see how she can help support your business. An excellent business resource here in the Tampa Bay community. Well, it's time to put on the belly dance performance. Johanna, who's been here in studio with us, talking about her business, Hip Expressions, and you can learn more about her at hip-expressions.com. But she's now going to perform a brief belly dance to the tune of Shakira's Hips Don't Lie. Johanna, it's all yours.
Hey, my show business became my business, so I don't know. You have some music for
yep,
me?
Yep, Steve, go ahead and put on the audio.
There we go. We can belly dance to anything.
No fighting. No fighting. Shakira, Shakira.
I never really knew that she could dance like this. She make a man want to speak Spanish. Como se llama? Bonita. Because
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh, baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. So be wise and keep on. I'm on tonight, you know my hips don't lie. And I'm starting to feel it's right. All the attraction, the tension. Don't you see, baby, this is perfection.
Hey, girl, I can see your body moving. And it's driving me crazy. And I didn't have the slightest idea until I saw you dancing. And when you walk up on the dance floor, nobody can ignore the way you move your body, girl. And everything's so unexpected, the way you right and left it. So you can keep on shaking it.
She could dance like this. She make a man wanna speak Spanish. Como se llama? Bonita.
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh, baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. So be wise and keep on reading the signs of my body. I'm on tonight, you know my hips don't lie. And I'm starting to feel you, boy. Come on, let's go real slow. Don't you see, baby, I see it's perfect.
Wow, great little performance. Yay. And I actually love that song by Shakira. That's one of my favorites as well.
Unexpected. Yeah, I now do fancier costumes. You'll have to come out and see a show.
Now, we didn't tell Sherry, but now it's Sherry's turn to get
I swear to God, I thought you were going to nominate me. She was trying to during the break.
I know. You would have been great.
Oh, great little
it's
performance.
It's hard work, though. It's a great workout.
Great little performance.
Ooh,
there.
Warm.
Huh? So, Johanna, tell us then, talk to us about memberships. How does your club work? I see you offer like a toolbox, introductory type of course. How does it work?
Yeah, well, the best thing to do is do our $30 for 30 days intro special. You can try all the classes. Sorry, I'm still out of breath. You can try all the classes, yoga, belly dance. Every instructor's different. Every class is different. So it's fun to try all the different classes. And then our monthly membership is $69 a month. Or they can do like an 8-class pass or 4-class pass or come out to one of our workshops.
So what do you wear to a belly dance class? Do people actually show up in like a midriff shirt or something and show off the belly or no?
You don't have to show your belly, but you can if you want to. But most women wear, you know, what you'd wear to yoga class. So yoga pants, tank top. And of course, the most important element is to have a hip scarf. So you can see all the hip movements, and your instructor can see your hip
movements.
What's
the origin of belly dancing? Is this like a Hawaiian thing of origin, or where is the origin?
It actually, so it comes from. It's such an ancient dance. If you talk to people from Egypt, they say it comes from Egypt. Turkey, they say it comes from Turkey. But the thing is that it's such an old dance. Back when we were tribes wandering in the deserts, we were belly dancing. It also comes from a woman's birthing rituals. And we often joke that it's a complete system because if it helps get the baby out, it's probably also what got you knocked you up in the first place. So, but it's very much
look at that.
But it's very much a dance of celebration. And it even has some spiritual basis as well.
Interesting. Is belly dancing hard to learn?
It's very easy to do. It's very easy to start getting the benefits right away. But to become good at it, it's just like any art form. You know, do you want to hear someone play violin after taking classes for a year? Maybe not. It might take a little bit longer. But if you want to just have fun and work out from the first day, you'll feel the effects.
And you're saying this is for people of all ages, shapes, and sizes, too. So you don't have to be a stick figure or anything to come
Absolutely.
In and enjoy belly dancing.
No, our average, you know, anyone from age 15 to 75. We have a woman who performs. Actually, she's 78 years old.
Wow. What's the youngest belly dancer you got in your studio?
Well, my friend's daughter was belly dancing before she could walk. So.
Oh, wow.
All ages.
Interesting stuff. Okay, and your location again is where? What's the street address?
54th Avenue North and 275. So it's 2033. 54th Avenue North. We're between Cracker Barrel and the school across from the graveyard.
And what are the hours you're open?
Most of our classes are evenings, so Monday through Friday, Saturday mornings, Sunday afternoons, and we're actually going to be expanding and adding more yoga classes during the day.
Awesome, awesome. All right, Sherry, let me throw it back over to you. Again, founder of Little Light of Mine, a startup 501c3 that helps with photography services for people facing end-of-life situations. I mean, how do you deal with this as a person? Is this obviously like a sad and somber situation for you? How do you handle this?
I would say it's intense and it can be very somber. And I will clarify too that there's a wide range. We do end of life. We have photographed children who are being disconnected from life support the day that we're there to do their last portraits. But we also photograph children who are in remission and, you know, so there is a wide range. Sometimes it looks like a regular photo shoot at the park where the children are frolicking around, and sometimes we're in a hospital room. So there is a wide range of families that we service. As far as like my mental state and how it affects me, you know, I have found that it is very intense and it can be very somber, but it is also very grounding. And you know, it's wonderful to give the gift to the families of the portraits that we end up taking, but it's also a tremendous gift to myself. And I think each photographer and each liaison that works with our families, it feels the same way. It's very grounding, you know, things that would typically bother you, like late bills and, you know, things that seem so epically huge. When you go in and you're introduced into this space, it's very sacred space when we go into, especially an end of life situation, you leave there and you know, all of those bills that were like really getting you down and felt like, you know, you couldn't get past don't matter at all. And it's just your perspective is completely changed. And so, you know, like Johanna was talking about with her cancer experience, you do tend to then live in the moment a little bit more, even though it's not your personal experience. Being exposed to that and feeling vulnerable and feeling absolutely blessed for your own health, and knowing that, you know, we are all fragile and we should be living in this moment. And you get, it's so easy to lose sight of that, you know, in our hectic, crazy, chaotic world.
It gives you appreciation for the people around you and the love that we do have in our life.
It does. It's really enriched my life on a level that I didn't expect, you know.
How many different shoots have you done, photography shoots for families in need right now?
I think that we're around the 200 mark.
Oh, wow.
I've done a lot of them myself, but in the last year, we've built the team of photographers. So now there's people that are kind of scattered around the Tampa Bay area.
And what has your 501c3 given back to you just on a personal level?
The 501c3
is your organization, your service that you provide to the families. What has it given back to you just on a personal level to yourself?
I mean, again, it's just the grounding and the perspective that I have. And, you know, as being living in more in a mindset of gratitude.
I would describe you as bubbly. I was in a bad mood this morning. I met this woman, and I'm not in a bad mood no more.
Awesome. My job here is done.
She came in cracking me up, and I was like, not really wanting to smile or laugh or nothing, but I couldn't help myself.
Else are we here?
I know. Yes.
What both else are we here on earth for except to spread love and light?
Both these ladies have lit up the room tonight. A great way to start Working Women Wednesdays.
I slept all wrong. I'm all hurting. She had me laughing all morning.
Let's come back to the need, though, for the 501c3. Again, donations.
Donations. You know, we are getting ready to rent a space, and we have a lot of build-out expenses, and, you know, we were getting very intimidated and actually starting to maybe doubt our decision to move forward with that, although we really need a space to shoot the families that are not hospitalized. We ended up getting a check randomly in the mail, and it's from the Bill Edwards Foundation. One of my friends on Facebook is a soccer mom, and they had a soccer game, and they could put in their charity of choice, and we ended up getting this $3,000 check. So, and for us, for our organization, $3,000 is a huge, huge, huge stepping stone for us. It's not just a stepping stone, it's really epic. But donations and volunteers as we grow and expand is what we need.
Well, we wish you the best luck. And you're looking for 100 people just to donate $15 a month. And you can make that commitment over at the website, llom.org. Sherry, thank you so much for being in studio. And thank you for so much for what you're doing to make a difference in our community.
Thank you.
Again, that was Sherry Kendrick, founder of The Little Light of Mine. And again, llom.org. And also thank you to Johanna Kranitsky, who was the belly dancer here in studio and co-founder and co-owner of Hip Expressions. Johanna, thank you so much. Great performance
today.
Thanks
for having us here today. It was a lot of fun.
Thank you very much. And you can learn more about her over at hip-expressions.com. And also, please help support the Working Women of Tampa Bay and visit workingwomenoftampabay.com. They got events going on each and every week, probably almost every day almost. So check out their calendar over there for the next upcoming event and visit tampabayradio.com for more information on this show. You've been listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.